Welcome to Siena Chalk Talk. I'm Paul Chedore, Photonic Systems Architect. Today we'll talk about maximizing the capacity of your fiber plant cost-effectively. As spectral efficiency gains from modem advancements slow, they're no longer sufficient to keep up with the growing traffic demands of our customers. As such, the need to expand the usable spectrum is vital to increasing total fiber capacity, especially for operators with fiber constraints. The agreed-upon next step is to deploy a C+L-band line system. You might think, more capacity with my existing fiber plant, sign me up. But the answer is more nuanced than that. There are different approaches to deploying C+L, and they're not all created equal. First is the conventional C+L-band. In this configuration, we have a 4.8 terahertz C-band and a 4.8 terahertz L-band, which together provides 9.6 terahertz of total spectrum. The second option widens the C-band to 6 terahertz while shifting the 4.8 terahertz L-band. This results in 10.8 terahertz of total spectrum, or an additional 12.5%. The last option offers 25% more spectrum than the conventional approach by widening both the C-band and the L-band to 6 terahertz for 12 terahertz of total spectrum. This leads to an L-band that extends substantially further towards longer wavelengths, as far as 1627 nanometers. You might assume that the system's capacity scales directly with the increase in bandwidth, and that the best option would be to adopt the offering with the most spectrum. Unfortunately, it's not that easy. What spoils the party is an effect called excited state absorption. This is when signal photons created by the amplification process get reabsorbed into the doped fiber before they get a chance to leave the amplifier. This effect is wavelength dependent, and it gets very pronounced around 1615 nanometer and beyond. While it may be possible to win the battle against physics and overcome the parasitic loss due to excited state absorption, it requires brute force. To achieve an equivalent gain in power spectral density output, the amplifier design requires considerably more erbium doped fiber, many more gain stages, and up to 3.5 times the total pump power. This inefficiency results in degraded performance that penalizes capacity across the spectrum. This effectively cancels out much of the benefit that comes from widening the bands beyond the conventional 9.6 terahertz. Coherent modems are forced to downshift to a lower rate to tolerate the extra noise, which in turn reduces the overall spectral efficiency at a network level. Let's consider a sample Tier 1 service provider's backbone network. In this example, deploying the 10.8 terahertz or 12 terahertz C+L band yields diminishing returns on their investment. The 10.8 terahertz option uses 12% more coherent transceivers, thus increasing the cost per bit. Extending to the wider 12 terahertz C+L band is even more inefficient due to a much steeper increase in excited state absorption. Sustainability and reliability are also of concern. Meeting energy consumption goals is important as costs soar and network providers work to decrease emissions. Using over 3 times the pump power to amplify a 6 terahertz L-band and adding 25% more modems goes against mandates to lower power use. Additionally, the larger number of pumps and the need for them to be very high power results in a 2 to 3 times increase in amplifier failure rates and the probability of service affecting failures. Because of these technical and economic considerations, Siena uses conventional C+L band architectures. We double your usable fiber capacity while keeping costs and power under control. We do this while delivering operational simplicity that matches or even improves on conventional C-band only designs. Adding wavelengths to the L-band can be done without any apprehension because we use channelized amplified spontaneous emission, or ASE, as pseudo-channels in the system, thus maintaining a stable loading throughout its operating life regardless of channel count. Siena's built-in instrumentation, automatic calibration, and optimization ensure that you always get the best possible performance on a span-by-span basis. That way, you won't need to re-optimize or re-engineer anything when you begin to add channels in the L-band. As you think about increasing your fiber capacity, it's important to look at the whole picture. It's about more than just added spectrum. It's about ensuring you get a meaningful capacity benefit in exchange for the cost per bit and watt per bit premium. With the technology challenges that currently exist, going beyond a 9.6 terahertz C+L-band simply does not make sense, and we don't see any game-changing technology on the horizon that would make us change this conclusion. At Ciena, we are continually researching and working with photonic component suppliers to understand the state of the industry and what's coming next. We understand the need to augment capacity on your network, and that the need is greater than just the increase that C+L band solutions wider than 9.6 terahertz deliver at all too great a cost. This is why we're investigating more novel approaches beyond the C+L. Stay tuned to hear more about these developments as they happen.